The term sakinah appears in the Quran and Hadith, and the scholars of Muhammad and Islam claim it to be an Arabic word. What are its actual roots?
There is actually a genuine Arabic word sakinah, meaning tranquility, from sakin, meaning to rest, to be quiet. Muhammad used it in his Quran with a totally ambiguous and unrelated meaning, because he plagiarized and perverted its actual significance, as he did with almost everything else of value in his Quran from the Bible. This word appears in the Quran only in the late Medinan passages while he was among the Judaized Arabs. Muhammad copied it perversely from the Hebrew word Shekhinah, most probably through Syriac of the Christian Arabs. In Hebrew, Shekhinah signifies the majestic presence of God among humans. It is used to express the immanence and omnipotence of the Almighty. The term also represents the divine presence, or Ruach HaKodesh, that is, the Holy Spirit. Muhammad would have learned this word from the people of the book, but, not quite understanding its connotation, he associated it with the genuine Arabic word meaning tranquility. This is why it gives the readers of the Quran and Hadiths a curiously mixed sense of the word. It is important to remind our listeners yet again, whether so-called believers or unbelievers, that almost every single intellectual, theological, and spiritual precept, concept, thought, or idea of value in the Quran were plagiarized, plundered, pirated, and/or perverted from the Hebrew Bible, the New Testament, Zoroastrian and pagan Arabian religions, their traditions, their fetishes, and their scriptures. Muhammad had to, since the very simplistic and primitive religion of the pagan Arabs had not evolved enough to create the words necessary to express the much more advanced and elaborate religious scripture, concepts, liturgy, and traditions. Al-Baqarah 2.248, and their prophet said to them, "A sign of his authority is that there shall come to you the Ark of the Covenant with an assurance therein of security, Sakinatu, from your Lord, and the relics left by the family of Moses and the family of Aaron carried by angels." The translator adds his own interpretation that security, Sakinatu, means safety, tranquility, peace. That later Jewish writings use the same word for the symbol of God's glory in the tabernacle, or tent in which the ark was kept, or in the temple when it was built by Solomon. Considering that the upstart revelations of the Quran were compiled at least 2,000 years after the Bible, it leaves a lot to be desired when the very learned and knowledgeable translator of the Quran asserts that it was later Jewish writing used the same word of Shekhinah. This is such a blatant and demonstrable lie that it is worthy only of a charlatan who has no self-respect, who appropriates to his traditions items that are plundered, pirated, and or perverted from others, but falsifies the facts about its origin. Unfortunately, both Muhammad's Quran and its followers have been doing so with impunity, with utter and complete disregard and contempt for the truth, history, and reality for the last 1400 years. Al-Tawbah 9.26. But Allah did pour His calm, Sakinatahu, on the apostle and on the believers, and sent down forces which ye saw not. He punished the unbelievers, thus doth He reward those without faith. The translator says, Sakina, calm, peace, security, tranquility. The word used for calm in this case is the Arabic Sakinatahu. The interpretation is false and wrong, because it should have meant that the Spirit of Allah had supported Muhammad. The interpreter is of course loath to admit this, for the obvious reason that it was pirated from the Hebrew Shekhinah. The expression, pour his calm, is meaningless otherwise. The same perverted meaning is indicated by the manner the word is inserted in the following verses also. Al-Fath 48.4. It is He who sent down tranquility, al-Sakinata, into the hearts of the believers that they may add faith to their faith. 48.18. He knew what was in their hearts, and he sent down tranquility, al-sakinata, to them, and he rewarded them with a speedy victory. 48.26. While the unbelievers got up in their hearts heat and cant, the heat and cant of ignorance, Allah sent down his tranquility, sakinatahu, to his apostle and to the believers, and made them stick close to the command of self-restraint. I repeat once again that the concept of the Shekhinah was not known among the pagan Arabs until it was plundered by Muhammad in his Quran from the Bible. For the interpreter to claim otherwise defies history, logic, morality, and veracity, but is nonetheless typical of the efforts made by almost all Muhammadan translators and interpreters. They attempt to show the Quran as superior and more original than the previous revelations of the Torah and the New Testament, even at the cost of contorting and disfiguring history and language. Al-Tabari 6.75. Messenger, how did you first know with absolute certainty that you were a prophet? He replied, two angels came to me while I was somewhere in Mecca. One angel said, open his breast and take out his heart. He opened my chest and heart, removing the pollution of Satan and a clot of blood, and threw them away. Then one said, wash his breast as you would a receptacle. He summoned the Sakina, which looked like the face of a white cat, and it was placed in my heart. Then one said, sew up his breast. So they sewed up my chest and placed the seal between my shoulders. The misuse of the word Sakina in the above borders on the blasphemy, since it is associated with the Spirit of God and cannot be represented by a cat-like apparition. This hadith actually proves that, as usual, Muhammad, his Quran, and the Muhammadan exegetes misunderstood the concept and created their own useless and dysfunctional ideas.